Hi guys, Mauricio Rosa from Promise Keepers Canada Impactus here. We are a global men's ministry. We equip men for a life of purpose and godly impact. History tells us that in the early 1900s, The Times, a London newspaper at the time, had sent out an inquiry to famous authors asking this question: what is wrong with the world today? And G.K. Chesterton, a Christian author and thinker, responded by simply saying this: "Dear Sir, I am, period. Yours, G.K. Chesterton." Well, whether this story is true or not, we don't really have any official record about it. But also, we don't know if anyone actually took the time to go through all the back issues and find a copy of the actual letter. Have you ever asked this question: what is wrong with the world? I'm very confident if there is a time in history that we would be asking this question, it is now. But the catch here is this: how do you answer this question? The Gospel of Luke is known to be a letter written to someone who was possibly a non-Christian or someone very intrigued and seeking about Jesus. So Luke, because of that, he is constantly challenging the religious status quo as he lays out the facts around the life and ministry of Jesus. So in this gospel, there is this parable that Jesus told about two men who go to the temple. And you only go to the temple to either offer worship or a sacrifice for your sins. So one man is a Pharisee and the other a tax collector. So the Pharisee essentially boasts about his life while the tax collector beats on his chest pleading for mercy. This illustration is much more than simply pointing out a religious zealot on one hand and a sinner on the other hand, because tax collectors were Jews who decided to work for Rome, the ruler of the nation at the time. They were not sinners in the sense of, oops, please forgive me for my sin. They were consciously men who had made a decision, a choice to betray their fellow Jews. So the circumstances around them, the weight of disapproval from the religious leaders and the population was heavy on them. And for a lot of people, they were responsible for what was wrong with their world. But in this story, Jesus dives much deeper to the heart of the matter. Jesus contrasts those who, like the Pharisee in this passage, have a real sense of being good and righteous, and those who, like the tax collector, don't even dare to raise their eyes. And the point of this whole passage is that neither the Pharisee nor the tax collector have any rights to raise their eyes. After all, Romans 3 says that we are all sinners, we all have sinned, and we all fall short of the glory of God. However, Jesus remarks that the one who readily acknowledges that he's a sinner leaves the temple justified in God's eyes. So like the Pharisees, we can look at the world around us and blame everything and everyone for what is wrong and deceive ourselves believing we are on the right side. That somehow we are not only better, but know precisely who's at fault. Or, like G.K. Chesterton and the tax collector, we can look deep inside of us and cry out to God, "God, be merciful of me, a sinner." One approach will lead us to God's grace and mercy, and will free us to go about our lives knowing that though we are sinners, we have been justified, made right with God. So, as you go today, who do you want to be? I want to invite you to join us this week as we will discover that we need to look no farther than ourselves to see the real problem. If you have not subscribed to our daily devotions yet, sign up at impactus.org. to receive it daily on your emails. Also, share this devotional with a friend and encourage them to sign up too. May the Lord bless you.